Okay, so now we are going to discuss the next topic, that is mechanism. Okay, so now we are going to discuss the next topic, that is mechanism. Okay, if you observe in our previous sessions or in our last sessions, we have discussed about the what is plastic analysis, okay, what are the assumptions, what is the graph that we are going to use, and some concepts like what is shape factor and how to calculate plastic moment carrying capacity. First of all, what is meant by plastic state? So once again, I repeat that important topic or that important concept, plastic state. What is meant by plastic state? If stress variation is uniform throughout the depth of the cross section, then it is plastic state. Clear? So when the cross section, particular cross section reaches to the plastic state, if you increase the load or if you place the load, more load on it, so finally it will reach to the plastic state. If you see or if you remember the things what we had discussed in the previous session, so there, because of the load P1, the material reaches to elastic state. If you increase the load further, P1 plus P2, then the material reaches to the yield state. If we still increase, then the material reaches to semi-plastic state. If we increase the load furtherly, then finally the very same material reaches to plastic state. Plastic state means all the fibers are stressed uniformly. So after plastic state, there exists no other state, only failure. Clear? So that is the thing. If you see the stress variation, all the fibers are stressed uniformly. Now if you increase the load, now nothing is there to take that load in that cross section. Now finally, if you increase only very little amount of load, once the material reaches the plastic state or reaches to the plastic state, then it is a failure or collapse condition. Clear? Now the next topic in it is mechanism. So if you observe the mechanism, so mechanism is nothing but, it is simply called as rigid body translation or rotation. So mechanism is nothing but rigid body translation or rotation. Okay, rigid body translation or rotation. Rigid body translation or rotation. It means, for example, so this is a marker. So if I throw this marker, then obviously as a rigid body it will move. So that is what that is known as rigid body translation. If the very same marker, if I rotate like this, okay, if I rotate like this, then it is called as rigid body rotation. So if such a phenomena happens or takes place in a structure, then it is known as mechanism. Agree? So write down what is mechanism. First of all, if the segments of a beam between the plastic hinges, if the segments of a beam between the plastic hinges if the segments of beam between plastic hinges are able to rotate without any further loading. Clear? So as we discussed, mechanism is nothing but simply rigid body translation or rotation. So what is meant by rigid body translation or rotation? I'll explain with an example. Take a simply supported beam. One end roller support and other end hinge support. So for this simply supported beam, if we place an internal hinge here, clear? So this is an internal hinge. So what is the deflected shape upon placing the internal hinge? This is how the beam is going to rotate. It means initially the beam is like this. Okay. The beam is like this. But because of placing internal hinge between, it will rotate like this. rigid body rotation. This is known as rigid body rotation. Means as a rigid body, it is rotating. So if such case happens in a structure, that is known as mechanism. So this is known as rigid body rotation. So this is rigid body rotation. So this is an internal hinge. Okay, this is an internal hinge. Take another simply supported beam. At both ends, place the roller support. Upon horizontal loading, we know that this beam will translate in this direction from here to here. So this is known as rigid body translation. Means from here to here, the beam has translated. So that is known as rigid body translation. So if such cases happens in our structure, then it is known as mechanism. Clear? This is known as rigid body translation. So this is about the mechanism. Now, next concept. Number of plastic hinges required at collapse. It means, see, if this mechanism takes place in our beam, then it is known as collapse. So for that collapse or for this mechanism to form, number of plastic hinges required. Let us see. See here, if you observe in this definition, it's segments of the beam between plastic hinges. If you see here, plastic hinges. So I guess in strength of materials, you have discussed what is meant by hinge. So this is an hinge, internal hinge. So if this hinge is formed in a plastic state, then it is known as plastic hinge. So now we are going to calculate the number of such plastic hinges required for the mechanism to form or for collapse to take place in a structure. Number of plastic hinges required. Let us see. Agree? Number of plastic hinges required at collapse. So as I said, collapse is nothing but forming the mechanism. Okay, collapse is nothing but forming the mechanism in a structure. That is mainly we are discussing a beam. So in beam. So forming the mechanism, collapse. Forming the mechanism in a beam is nothing but collapse. So now at that collapse, how many plastic hinges required? So we represent with n, small n. So the number of plastic hinges required for the formation of collapse is ds plus 1. So where ds? Again, I guess everyone knows what is ds. Ds is nothing but degree of static indeterminacy. Degree of static indeterminacy. So this is what? Static indeterminacy. So now, once again, I guess everyone knows what is meant by static indeterminacy, but once again, repeat or revise the things what is meant by static indeterminacy. So static indeterminacy is nothing but number of reactions in excess of equations of equilibrium is known as degree of static indeterminacy. Once again, I repeat. So degree of static indeterminacy is nothing but number of unknown reactions in excess of equations of equilibrium. So what are the equations of equilibrium we are having? Summation of forces in x direction equal to 0. That is one equation of equilibrium. And summation of force in y direction equal to 0. That is another equation of equilibrium. And summation of moments equal to 0. So these are the three equations of equilibrium we are having. So if there exists any reaction in excess of these equations of equilibrium, then that is known as static indeterminacy, degree of static indeterminacy. So just I'll explain a small example. Take the two cases, fixed beam. So before going into this, example 1 and 2, let me remind you the types of supports and the reactions they can offer. So what are the types of supports we are having? Hinged support. So hinged supports, how many reactions it can offer? Reactions, 2. What are those 2? Vertical and horizontal. So those are the 2 reactions offered by a hinged support and roller support. So this I guess in structure analysis and in both in strength of materials you are going to study. So this is the roller support. roller support can offer how many reactions? R is equal to 1. So only vertically it cannot offer horizontal reaction. That is, it will move in an horizontal direction. It can translate in horizontal direction. Next, fixed support. Fixed support, how many reactions it can offer? It can offer horizontal, vertical reaction, horizontal reaction, and then moment. So it can offer R is equal to 3. So for a time being, you just remind about or remember about these three supports. Of course, we are having some other supports like moment roller. Okay, moment roller and some other two supports. But no need of those supports. So no need of going into the details of those supports at this point. So you simply remember about these three basic supports. Clear? Engine support, it can offer two reactions, horizontal, vertical. Roller support, it can offer only vertical reaction. Fixed support, it can offer three reactions. So now come to here. Fixed support. So for this case, first case, tell me what is static indeterminacy? How to calculate? So at this, how many reactions it can offer? We know that fixed support can offer three reactions. So or vertical, horizontal, and then moment, three. Here, three reactions. Here, again, same. Vertical, horizontal, and moment. So again, here also the three. So total number of reactions is equal to 6. Agree? How many equations of equilibrium we're having? Equations of equilibrium we're having is 3. What are those 3? Summation of forces. X. Sigma x is nothing but summation of force in x direction equal to 0. And the summation of forces y. Sigma y is equal to 0 means summation of force in y direction equal to 0. And the summation of moment equal to 0. These three are the three reactions. So sigma x equal to 0, sigma y equal to 0, and sigma m equal to 0. Now ds in this case is equal to r minus c, which is equal to 6 minus 3 is 3. So for the first case, the ds is 3. For the first case, ds is 3. Now coming to the second case. So in the second case, there exists a load w. So now for this case, how to calculate the ds? Always remember, if in a given question, in the calculation of degree of indeterminacy, first we have to check whether the beam is generalized, the beam given or structure given in that question is generalized structure or any particular loading. If you see the first case, it is generalized case. It means loading is not mentioned. So it means as the loading is not mentioned, so we can assume that load may be horizontal or vertical or inclined. So if you assume inclined, so then that can be resolved into horizontal and vertical components. So that support has to offer resistance in both horizontal and vertical direction. So you're getting the point or not? So if anything is not mentioned for a given structure, mainly beam in a question, then we have to consider most generalized loading, that's inclined loading. It means horizontal and vertical both. That is the reason we have considered all the reactions that the support can develop. But the second case is the particular loading. It means generally, if you take the any beam in our practical case, so whatever the beams you are going to see in our day-to-day life or in practical cases, so all the beams are subjected to vertical loading, no doubt. But if anything is not mentioned, then we have to consider most generalized case. It means of inclined load. It means both horizontal and vertical. But here the loading is given, vertical. So for that vertical loading, it can offer only vertical reaction, but not horizontal reaction. That is, there is no horizontal reaction. So why the horizontal reactions will develop? As there is no horizontal load, so no horizontal reaction. So no need to consider horizontal reactions here. Even though this support can develop horizontal reaction, but there is no horizontal loading. So that is the reason no need to consider the horizontal reaction in this case. That is what I am saying. So this is the tricky point in the calculation of DS, degree of static indeterminacy. What is that point? If anything is not mentioned, means if beam is given simply, if loading is not mentioned, then we have to consider most generalized loading. But if any particular loading is mentioned, then according to that load, we have to proceed and we have to calculate DS. It means in this case, only vertical load. So it can offer only vertical reaction, even though it can develop horizontal. But here in this case, the horizontal reaction is equal to 0. And it can develop moment. Now, how many reactions in this case? 2 plus 2. Reactions is equal to 4. And equations of equilibrium equal to 3. Now, DS in this case is 4 minus 3, 1. Sorry. See here. Here equations of equilibrium we have to consider 2. What are those 2? sigma y equal to 0 and sigma m equal to 0. No need to consider sigma x equal to 0. No need to consider sigma x equal to 0. The reason, as there is no urgent reaction, so that equation equilibrium has no use here. That is the reason, no need to consider sigma x equal to 0. So now, 4 reactions and 2 equations of equilibrium, so total ds equal to 2. So we have to be very careful. If you take the generalized condition, in that case, for very same fixed beam, ds is 3. But if a vertical loading is given, then it is 2. So get rid of that confusion. So for same fixed support, if no loading is given, then ds is 3. If loading is given, ds is 2. So as I said, this is only the tricky part in the calculation of the degree of static indeterminacy. So regarding the static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy, you are going to discuss in structural analysis in detail. Clear? But here, for the calculation of number of plastic hinges required at collapse load, we require ds. That is the reason just I have revised it. That's it. But in detail, I guess you have discussed or you are going to discuss in structural analysis. Clear? So this is about the static indeterminacy. So always remember one thing. First, for a given structure, we have to check whether it is a generalized loading or a particular loading. That's it. If you know it, we can do it. Take it out.